Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in to another video with Rock Island Auction Company. I'm Joel Colander. We're going over some of the guns that are going to be highlighted in our September 6th, 7th, and 8th, 2019 Premier Firearms Auction. And today we have a tale of two survival rifles. From World War II era, we have the German and we have the American versions, and just sort of the implications they have for the fighting forces that they served at large. First and foremost, the American version. Now, this will actually not be in the premier sale. This will be in an upcoming online only auction, but I brought it as a strict comparison just to show a point. This is the American, or the modern reproduction of the American M6, now called the M6 Scout. They've been remade by a number of modern companies. Originally, they were issued with a 14-inch barrel. Now they've been issued with an 18.5, because this is a combination gun. On top, they were originally issued in 22 Hornet, and underneath with a 410 shotgun. As you can see, they're pretty Spartan. They're pretty austere. You don't even get a fore end. The manual for these recommended wrapping your parachute cord around it if you had to make a forced landing and really felt the need for a fore end. Stamped metal, a lot of stamped metal parts, but they work. They would break open. You'd have them stored like this in the plane. When it came time, you can, as you can see, you can load a 410 on bottom, your 22 Hornet up top. You have an extractor, like most break action firearms. Latches shut, you can cock, and when you're ready to fire, there's not even a set trigger or trigger guard so that they could be used if you were in a cold weather environment, if you had large mittens or gloves on. It's just a large squeeze trigger down here at the bottom that you squeeze to fire a shot. In the buttstock, they do hold, with a release button on this side, they do hold some spare ammo, four extra rounds of the 410 shotgun shells, and about a dozen rounds of 22 Hornet. And that's what the Americans got. If you were a downed pilot, this is what you could expect to have, not to defend yourself, but definitely to find some food if you were waiting to be rescued. On the other side of the fence, you have the German Luftwaffe survival drilling. And it perfectly illustrates the German excess, or rather the German refined nature of things they did during World War II. And it's that refinedness is exactly why we love the weapons like the Luger, like the P-38, like the MP-40, the STG-44, FG-42. They feel like glass. They are so well put together. This drilling is no exception. You make that a gross comparison to say American survival rifles or even their tanks, the German tanks, versus say if you see a Russian T-34 where maybe even the corners aren't fully welded. It's just a perfect example of the German excess and refined nature of their products that they made in wartime. The drilling is called a drilling because it has three barrels, and the German for three is Ein, zwei, drei. So you have a drilling, which is two shotgun barrels on top. Those are 12-gauge shotgun. And on bottom, you do have a rifle barrel, and that is 9.3 by 74R. It's roughly equivalent to a 375. That is a large rifle round to be carrying on a survival piece. What we consider the head of the Luftwaffe was Erwin Rommel, who was also a very, very avid hunter, a big game hunter. It starts to make a little more sense. We can just take a look at it from stem to stern. We have beautiful wood. We have a nice cheek piece. We have a safety selector switch on the side. There's lots of case hardening. There's lots of blue, not only down the barrel, not only on the sling swivels, but even on the brake action lever here. In addition to the case hardening in blue, we have loaded shader indicators on each side of the brake action lever and engraving. Now, the fine nature of this arm should come as no surprise, is that they were manufactured by Sauer & Son, well-known German manufacturer. This is actually sort of a military version of their 1930 of a sporting rifle that they would sell in the commercial markets. Now, the Luftwaffe ordered over 4,000 of these. Only about 2,500 were delivered before someone in higher places realized that maybe you don't want to be issuing such expensive arms to airline pilots who are making forced landings. But it doesn't just look like a fine rifle, it performs like one as well. After switching our safety switch here, quick break open to load, all three would eject. Nice crossbar locking. We have it on shotgun setting right here. Here's our selector for shotgun and rifle. If we do have it on shotgun, we do have a nice bead sight up front here to use. Our front trigger fires our right barrel. Our rear trigger fires our left barrel. Both of those are then indicated with the indicator buttons back here. After that, the triggers are dead, but we can switch up to our rifle, and then our front trigger fires our rifle round. Now, one very, very cool, in fact, I think probably the coolest part about this entire rifle is that when you switch from shotgun to rifle with this thumb selector on top of the wrist, there's a button to push down and you slide it up. And as you slide it up, you have a rear leaf sight rated for 100 yards that flips up. And so now your bead, your shotgun bead up front becomes your front sight. This becomes your rear sight, and you're sighted out to 100 yards. That is on top of a very nice matte rib to reduce glare. Should also mention that while the rifle is sighted to 100 yards, the left shotgun barrel for slug is also designed to converge at 100 yards with the rifle sights. And a fine drilling like this isn't meant to just be rattling around the cockpit. So they would come in a aluminum carrying case like the one seen here. Painted olive green, the drilling of course breaks down to go in there, and they're also served with 20 slugs. You'd have 20 rifle rounds and 25 rounds for birdshot. Not to mention the cleaning tools, there's an instruction manual, there's everything you need would be in this little kit right here. So ladies and gentlemen, whether you love German military arms or US military arms, or you just love to compare the two, when it came to survival rifles, there really wasn't much comparison at all. The good news is, whether you love German military or US military, you will find them all in the September 6th, 7th, and 8th Premier Firearms Auction at Rock Island Auction Company. To find your next collector firearm, head over to our website, www.rockislandauction.com. Use our helpful search feature, and we can help you find your next collector firearm. We'll see you in September for our 6th, 7th, and 8th Premier Firearms Auction.